Hey, good evening everyone. How are you all today? Today we'll be starting with a new topic. So this was the topic we have done in the last session where we discussed about what is hypothesis, theory, knowledge and law, and what is the exact difference between all of these. Okay, moving forward, this is entirely in Hindi also, and you can get the Hindi videos on my YouTube channel. You can just go through the videos and just get. Okay, now let's start with the characteristics of research. Characteristics are, you can say, these are features, and sometimes these are also considered as nature. Okay, so characteristics of research is very important to understand research in a deeper manner so that we don't have any kind of confusion related to what exactly is research and what things are not included in research. So to get more clarity on research topic, I think characteristics of research or features of research are a great way to start. Okay, so let's start. Now I'm going point wise, so you can just follow me with this, and if you want you can make your own notes and write the keywords, because in any of your examination, it can be a NET examination or any examination you are preparing for, keywords are very, very important. Keywords help you to get to the answer, to find the exact answer. So keywords are very, very important. Okay, so a systematic approach is followed in research. So systematic here means a step by step. It means it can include a process or it is something step by step. Fine. So this is very, very important. Research is based on logical reasoning and involves both inductive and deductive. So what are inductive and deductive methods? That we'll be discussing in the further videos, but right now I could say it is based on logical reasoning. Like, it should have a reason, a logic behind everything, a scientific cause and effect relationship. So whatever happens, science believes it happens for a reason. If there is no reason, nothing is going to happen, right? So here, whatever in research you have concluded, there should be a reason for your conclusion. There should be a valid reason for whatever you are saying. You should back up all your conclusions with the data, with the analysis of the data and everything. The data or knowledge is derived in real time. So it is derived in real time. It is not a fake data. It is something which is original, which you have collected yourself or with the help of others. Actual observations in the natural setting. So it is the real data we are talking about. These are not assumptions. Hypothesis can be made, but hypothesis is not made on data. Okay. There is in-depth analysis. In-depth analysis. Analysis means to understand each and everything, to understand the bits and the pieces. So research is a deep analysis of all the parts of a system of or all the things of a particular concept or a topic. So research is an in-depth analysis of all the data collected from research so that there are no anomalies, means confusions. So this here means confusion. So there are no confusions associated with it. So if you are doing a proper research, it should be a very deep research. It should include all the elements. You should not ignore any of the elements. And secondly, it should not be confusing. Like, at the end of the day, when you conclude your research, there should be no confusion on the particular part. Okay. Research creates a path for generating new questions. Yes, as you bring new concepts into the light, as you try to understand the new topics, then what happens is it generates new questions. So yes, this is very important for you to understand that one research, one particular topic which you have focused on or which you have stated or which you have concluded in your research, it would lead to many new questions. So one research can be one research can result into many of the questions. There was a previous year question in NTA UG CNET which stated that one research gives birth to many research, and which is exactly true from this particular statement. More research opportunities can be generated from existing research. Research is analytical in nature. Analytical means to understand in a deep manner. Makes use of all available data, so there is no ambiguity. Ambiguity means confusion, or a word having two different meanings are ambiguous meanings. So it is confusion again. Okay, So this point is basically a more extended form of this point. These both points are almost same. Accuracy, yes. You need something which is very accurate. It should not be which has mistakes or something wrong. No, it should be very, very accurate. The data should be very, very accurate. The entire thing is in Hindi again. You can watch it if you want. The next one is gathers new knowledge. Yes, because of research, you get new knowledge. You get updated knowledge. Emphasis on discovery of new principles. Yes, you get to understand new principles, new theories, new law only with the help of research. Employs reliable data gathering services. Whatever data you're gathering, you should employ or you should use reliable data gathering services rather than taking any data randomly. Research must be logical. Yes, this we have just concluded in the last slide. Objectivity. Yes, there should not be a chance of subjectivity. So there are two things, objective and subjective. Subjective is when you put your own point of view, and there is a bit of biasness in subjectivity because of your previous experiences or your knowledge. You are subjective towards certain things. So in subjectivity, there are chances of being either being partial or either stating your own opinion rather than stating the facts. So that is a possibility. But when we are talking objectively, objectively is purely based on the knowledge. It's purely based on the research. It does not have any kind of partiality or any kind of biasness in it. So research should be objective in nature and not subjective in nature. This is very important, which you need to remember. Hypothesis oriented. Yes, many of the researchers are hypothesis based. Only after assuming hypothesis, you'll get to know the right answer. So yes, many of the researchers are hypothesis based. And yes, this is also true that many of the research is not based on hypothesis. That can also be the case. The next one is organizes data in quantitative form. Yes, you need the data in quantitative form as much as possible. Like many of the researchers are qualitative in nature. So when we are talking about quality, we cannot measure the quality in terms of numbers. For example, if I talk about sadness, depression, so I cannot give a number to how much sad I am. Like I'm 28% sad or I'm 15% sad. I cannot put a number on that, right? But still, as much as possible, like if you have seen these kind of questions in various questionnaires or in various Google forms, there's a question like, how do you feel? Slightly agree, strongly agree, slightly disagree, strongly agree, and neutral. So what are these? These are, we are trying to understand the range. Though we are not getting the exact amount, we are somewhere near to the exact amount. So that is quantitative form. So you should try to collect the data as much as possible in quantitative form. Okay, the next is patient and persistent activity. Okay, to all the people who do not know, PhD is a course where you need to give around 3 to 5 years of your life to gain the PhD degree. So it is a very patient activity. You cannot be like an impatient person. I want to do research today, but I don't want to do it tomorrow. You will not get a degree. So even if it is a PhD degree or an independent research, it is a very patient activity. You have to wait for the result. You have to wait for the data to be collected. You have to wait to understand the data and everything. So you have to be very patient and persistent. Persistent means you have to have the same level of enthusiasm the first day of the research and the last day of the research. So you cannot come half the way and be lethargic or lazy, like now I don't want to do this. You cannot do that. So that will not be, with that attitude, you'll not be able to complete your research. Leads to careful generalization and conclusions. Yes, because of the research, you'll be able to carefully generalize and conclude your research. So these are the basic characteristics of research. I hope you have understood this. If there is any doubt in any of the points, you can just mention in the comment section. I'll of course try to help you out. Take good care of yourself. Study hard, everyone. Bye.